Hello, welcome to Orphan Espresso. I'm Doug.
And I'm Barb.
And this is the OE Pharos 2.0 manual coffee grinder. I'm out of the box, I'm all set up, and I'm ready to use the grinder. Now, we'll have a short tutorial, try to keep this short, to show you. Okay, it comes with the burrs completely locked together. You lock the burrs by tightening this adjustment collar, this split collar, okay? It's a threaded collar that threads up and down on a threaded shaft. When you turn the collar counterclockwise, the gap gets larger. You turn it clockwise, the gap gets smaller. Now, I'll start here. As I said, the burrs are locked tightly together. Let me show how to make your first adjustments. And I'll go ahead and use the included wrench. Make sure you're seated squarely in the socket. This is a 4mm hex tool. Now I can turn. Okay. I'm creating a larger and larger gap as I go counterclockwise. Now, this is easy to see on the side. You come in, see that, Barb?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Here, I have no movement. Creating a gap. The gap is here. Also, it's a burr gap. Okay? Now, one kind of point of art is establishing your zero point. Now, I pull this out until the burrs are together. Stopped. No movement. Now, I can move this a lot farther than this point. We've included this is a Teflon washer under the adjustment collar. So I can squeeze that washer a little bit, and I can also pull the burrs together even harder. See, I can really go much farther than that point. Now, the burrs are really locked together at this point. Okay, you can't turn the handle, whole mechanism's locked, but this is really overkill. Okay, so let me show you my zero again. Pull the burrs together. Spin it until it stops. No movement. Back a little. A tiny bit of movement. This is basically for you, the new owner, to establish where is that zero. Where are you going to start? That's how I do it. I spin it with my finger. Don't even grasp it. See, I have no movement. I'll take that as my zero point, okay? Bart says move on, so I will. All right, now, got some dirt on my new grinder. Oh, that's gone. All right, so, I've gone down until it stops. That's my zero point, and I keep going over and over it because it confuses people, all right? Now, here I am. I have a clock face that I'm looking at. 12 o'clock, 9, 6, 3. My first espresso setting is going to be around 3/4 of a turn. Okay? I go counterclockwise with the pointer, 3/4 of a turn. Then I tighten my bolt. Now, I'm going to say something about tools. Okay, this is a standard, is that okay, Barb?
Can
I
talk
about this? All right, this is a standard L hex key. It's a 4mm key, okay? This is a standard issue. Now, you got all kinds of, these are all 4mm hexes. There's straight ones, there's ball heads. This is a great one, this is a high voltage key. This is a Weha made in Germany for high voltage electricity. There's another straight one, there's a T. There's a longer T. There's kind of a swoopy thing with this. There's a really long T, you know? Another Weha. And so, you know, I've got a whole pile of tools here to choose from. This tool here, that's kind of got a small handle on it. This is our friend Amber who works on assembling these grinders. I don't touch that, I won't touch it, okay? This one to me is a great tool, but it's a little long and clumsy. This used to be long and I cut it off. This is my tool. This is my favorite tool to use for this task, okay? If you find that you've got a problem with this tool, like if your eyesight is going bad, like some people I know, if you're a little clumsy, go out and get a better tool. If you don't like this tool, get a better tool. Get a tool that you like better. It might even be a cheaper tool or a worse tool. I know I shouldn't spend my time talking about this, but it's kind of important, you know? In other words,
the world is better when you use a tool that's right for you.
Right, but this is the tool we include. It's perfectly satisfactory to get you started. Okay, but I'm going to use this tool when I do this job because, see, I just come right in here. I can see it.
Now you're at three-quarters of a turn from the original zero.
From my original zero, okay? And I tighten this. That's my first shot. That's my three-quarters mark. I find it to be a good place to start. Now, if I want to make a small adjustment, I come in, I hold the handle still, I loosen this, and I make my small adjustment. I'm using the tool to make the adjustment in a fine direction or a coarse direction. Now, this brings to light, I'll go back, see, no movement, there's my zero.
So you've gone back to zero.
I've gone back to zero. I mean, I've used these a lot, so I don't have to turn it on its side every time, but it's a good thing to do. Now, this illustrates something that is likely going to happen to everybody. It's something that really can't be controlled is the positions of the threads on the axle. Relative to the setting. Now, what has happened here is that at my three-quarter mark, I'm at zero, so I go out. Okay, let me start this again. Here I am here. When I come out to three-quarters, my pointer is under the handle on this particular grinder. They're not all this way. See my pointer's under the handle? Okay?
Uh-huh, there it is.
So I want to change the orientation of this handle on this grinder. And what I do is I tighten this down really tight, tighten the adjustment screw down really tight. So I want to take the handle off. And when you take the handle off, you can loosen it up like this. This is a 10 millimeter key or 10 millimeter shaft for the handle.
And you put a washer over the threads under the handle.
Put a washer over the threads under the handle. Now,
tighten this back up. Now, the pointer is no longer under the handle.
No, I haven't hit my three-quarters yet, so you just wait.
Patience.
All right. Now, I go three-quarters. And my pointer is out here. My hex is there. So that washer really, really changed the life for me on this grinder. Your grinder might not have this issue, okay? Because the threading is kind of random on how it turns out. So now that I have my three-quarters point, I hold these two things still. I take my tool.
Boy, the wind's really blowing.
Yeah, the wind is blowing. It's a windy day in Taichung. Kind of cold, too. Okay, now my orientation is better to work with. So let's say I need to make a small adjustment. I did my first three-quarters, it's too fast or too slow. Let's say that it's too fast and I want to go finer.
I can't see the marks.
Can't see the marks?
No, the light.
Light's screwing you up?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now I can see them.
You see them now?
Yes.
Okay, so I want to go finer. So I hold the mechanism still, handle and nut, loosen the bolt, hold the handle still, one, two. Okay, one, two. I hold it still, come in here, and tighten my, I tighten just like that, okay? Now I have gone a little bit finer, okay? Is that really clear? As you see, it's best to make small adjustments relative to the last adjustment, rather than going back over and over and over to zero. This is an exercise in futility, unless you're a total expert at finding that exact same spot of zero where you stopped last time, okay?
It's much better to just make your adjustment relative to the last spot.
Right. As you can see, another thing you can do is you can, after you've used the grinder for a while, you begin to get an idea how big that gap should be. You know, that's pretty good right there, but dialing in is dialing in. It's the same thing with any grinder.
It's different with every bean and every machine.
Right, but you set it up, you get ready to go, and you make adjust, you hold the handle still, make a small adjustment. Okay? I think that's pretty clear. When you grind coffee, this is our top. You put in your beans. This is the top that keeps the shards from grinding out. This acts as a little hopper. Yeah. Okay. Now, catch cup is under here. Use two hands to push down on the spring. Out comes the catch cup. Kind of a nice thing is that this is a basket, filter basket. This is a stainless steel OE dosing funnel at 58 millimeter. You can also use this to slide that in, and you can grind directly into a portafilter basket if this is your desire. Okay? All of our dosing funnels actually have the same outside diameter of the big part, so they'll all work. I mean, as far as I know, they're all 83 millimeters something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So a 49 is the same outside diameter as a 58.
Will work as well in the basket.
Okay? So the as far as maintenance issues, I can't really think of that many. We're going to have a video coming up of installing the kits, so you'll see how I take this all apart and put it all together. But I really can't think of anything more as far as we need to talk about here.
Be controlled in your use of water to limit your static.
That's a good point. If you do what they call RDT, you'll add a drop of water or a little squirt of water. This is a steel, this is a piece of steel, okay? Coffee oil will protect this metal up to a point. If you just flood the whole thing with water, you might be asking for some trouble. Well, the wind is really railing, isn't it?
It is, it is.
Okay, so, and we might get some water from the sky.
Yes, we might.
But the putting water, small amount of water in the beans, it does help to control static if you're having issues with it, but you know, be under control as far as how to do it.
And read the manual.
And I did want to say that we can stabilize our grinder by using a, can you see this bar? See the bench dog back here?
If you move your hand.
Okay.
Yes.
And it still comes out, you know, that's the method that we use to do. We call it a bench dog, and we hold it down. We don't permanently affix the grinder to a table or anything like that, because one of the things about it is that after you grind coffee,
it's nice to be able to
knock whatever extra coffee on the
burrs. Or take it out and clean it with air.
Yeah, you take it out. You know, it's easy if you're going to come under the side. You can get in and you can brush it off and clean it with air, and you know, this is pretty stalwart. You can't really hurt it. So I hope I covered some things. And so anything more to say? Anything
no,
you want to
I
add?
Think that covers it.
Okay, there we are. That's the Pharos 2.0 video manual. I hope this helps, and I hope you enjoy your grinder.